What's going on, guys? T-Mart here, and welcome back to another episode of Forza Motorsport 6. Here we go, guys. All right, so we have two races left in this series that we're currently in. We started off in this series, the GTR. We had fantastic success with that. Then we moved on to the Aston Martin V12 Vantage S, because we had a free one of those. And now we have to decide how we want to end this series, because there's two races, so really one car. I was thinking about doing the 2015 Corvette Z06, but if you guys remember back in episode 11, I believe it was, we actually used it for like a challenge. So technically we already have used that car, and if we can save $117,000, then I feel like that'd be a pretty good move. I was thinking about potentially doing the TVR Cigaris, but I don't know about that. We do have a free Aston Martin here, a V12 Zagato, and I figured if it's free, why not? I mean, obviously it's a sick car, it's an Aston Martin, and it's something you don't really see a lot of. Like, you see a lot of, you know, DB9s and stuff like that, but the Zagato, you don't see much of. So I'm gonna see what we can do here. See, ooh, is this kind of like a speed racer looking one? Orange and light blue. Seahawks one, where the Vikings at, baby? Lots of flames. I don't know how crazy I am about some of these. The black and yellow doesn't look bad. Wiz Khalifa would approve of that. We're gonna see manufacturer colors. Interesting. Or we could go out there, dude. We could go crazy with it. We could go gold. You guys wanna do a chrome gold Aston Martin? Let's do a chrome gold Aston Martin. Why not? All right, so we're gonna have to buy it for 51,850 credits. That's all right. It's no big deal. It's cheaper than buying that $112,000, $119,000.
This is your 2012 Corvette. Aston Martin V12 Zagato.
All right, there she is, boys. Oh man, we balled out, son. We put the gold on it.
Your next race will be at Road Atlanta, host to Can-Am, Stock Car, Petit Le Mans, and Grand Prix events.
Cool. All right, I have no clue how much the V12 Zagato costs. So I'm gonna look this up right now. I wanna see. It looks like, I don't know much about this car. It looks like there are only 750 made. Whoa! $450,000. Okay, so this is an extremely rare car. Wow, that's crazy. All right. Cool. I didn't realize this was that big of a deal, but it looks like we have a, dude, this is crazy. A $450,000 chrome gold Aston Martin. Let's go. All right. So we're going to start off racing outside of the car. We're going to make our way inside for the second race. Looks like we're going to be starting off in 13th place, 14th place. Five laps here. Oh, that was very mean, Mr. GTR. I don't know if I appreciate that. Go ahead and blow by. Not quite sure how we just did that. Almost caused an accident back there. We're all right. We're moving our way back up. This thing's got some punch in her. I think it was rated at like 750 as a super. So that's pretty good. I like this black one here. This would probably look better like blacked out. That's all right. Forcing finger for goats right now. What in the world? Nice. All right. In the ninth place. I'll take it. That turn wasn't the best, but we're going to be all right. We've got to get up into that podium position, bros. We had a rough start. We were right there in the middle of all the action. And we just kind of fell behind a little bit. S turn. The infamous S snake turn. Sorry, Mr. Viper. Right, I'm coming for you, Mr. Old School Corvette. It's funny because this is actually the track that we used that Z06 2015 Corvette in episode 11. So if you guys, I feel bad because I was totally planning on buying that. Like I had mentioned it in the previous episodes. And then I remembered that we had already used it, and I didn't want to double up and use it again. I want to We have limited money in this game, so I want to make sure that every episode we do something new, just to make it more fun. So that's my reasoning behind it. Came in a little bit hot right there. So. This guy. All right, we're into sixth. We've got our target in our sights here. Turn there. So, that apex. All right. Here we go, boys. Got this S turn coming up, and that's going to be. Anytime we turn, that's a good opportunity to gain some ground on people. I feel like this is not the fastest car on straights. But turns, we'll be able to make it up. Oh yeah. That was fantastic right there. Sorry, GTR. Had to do it, man. All right, we're into fifth place, boys. Into fourth place. Should put us into third. Gotta pass this advantage. Yeah, dude, like you see a lot of advantages, you see a lot of DB9s, you see a lot of stuff like that. Zagato, I mean, I knew kind of the car, I don't know a lot of details on it, but you don't hear about those too much. So that's why I was kind of excited that we had a free one. The fact that it's a $450,000 car that we got for 50 grand is pretty good too. Sorry, man, sometimes you gotta race a little bit dirty. Watch out for those cones back there, bud. Alright, here we go, boys. We're in second. I want to try to get first if we can. There. First is starting to pull away a little bit though. Oh gosh. Lapse of vision there for a second. I just had, today I went and I got my eyes checked up on because I haven't done it in like probably like a year and a half, and I've had the same pair of contacts in for like 3.5-4 months now, and it's they're supposed to be thrown out every 2 weeks, but I was too lazy. Oh gosh. I was too lazy to go to the eye doctor. I need to pay attention to the road right now. Anyway, so I finally went today. My reasoning behind it was I wanted to make sure that when Black Ops 3 came around, like, since I had been on this, I didn't have any backups. Like, this is my last pair of contacts. And so if something happened, like, you know, sometimes over time they get flimsy and they rip and stuff like that. So if something happened with my contact, I wouldn't be able to see, and I'd have to go to the eye doctor. And I didn't want that to happen during Black Ops 3. And, you know, all the other huge games coming out. So I didn't want to... I was like, if like the middle of November when, you know, Fallout and Black Ops, you know, these things are out and I'm going to be recording nonstop, I would absolutely flip my lid if I had to go spend like 3 hours at an optometrist getting checked up on. So I went today and they did some crazy stuff to me, dude. Like, it was weird. It was like kind of in an upscale area. Like, if you guys remember I think it was Super Cooper Sunday when I was talking about Windermere, Florida. I went to one in Windermere, and that's like where all like Tiger Woods and Shaq and stuff live. So it was an upscale one, so they like take really good care of you, obviously. And she like put all this stuff in my eyes that dilates them. So my pupils were literally the size of my eyes. Like the colored area wasn't there anymore. It was just like black like holes in my eyes. And it made it so that I couldn't see anything up close, like anything 5 feet in front of me was just straight blurry. Like I could hold my phone up to my face and couldn't see, but then at a distance I could see like a hawk, which is completely reversed of what my vision normally is. Like I usually can see up really well up close, and then if I can't see very well at a distance. So it was just like, it was a really weird feeling. I was super sensitive to light and stuff like that. My eyes are still kind of messed up. So I feel like I find myself kind of zoning out and I almost like don't see things sometimes. So I don't know. Luckily, we're driving in a video game right now and not in real life. Because I've had a couple of moments, especially that one where we almost crashed, that sent me off on this tangent that it's just like I kind of zone out because it's like, I don't know. There's weird stuff going on with my eyes right now. I don't know how long it takes for these drops that she gave me to wear off, but it's definitely not feeling. All right, so I'd venture to say we're not gonna take first here. I think if we wouldn't have had that mistake, we could have, but I don't think we're gonna make up the ground that that guy has on us, so we're gonna have to just go ahead and be comfortable with second. I'm not upset with that. I think we're gonna be able to get first place in the next race once we hop inside the vehicle. We'll see what happens, but I'm feeling confident. I'm feeling confident, baby. All right, yeah, he just passed. He just passed it. Get back over. There it is, boys, second place. It's not ideal, but I'll take it. Okay. What are we gonna get? Yes, this is my favorite. Wish us luck. Oh my gosh. Bugatti Veyron, Hennessy Venom GT, Pagani Huayra. Yes! Woo! It's still one of the cheaper options we could have gotten there, but at least it wasn't a very cheap thing. I would have loved the Huayra. I would have loved the Veyron. I would have loved the McLaren P1. But getting a Hennessy Venom is huge, dude. That is, oh man, that feels good. That feels fantastic. All right, next race, let's get it.
Your next race will be at the Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps, home of the Belgian Grand Prix.
The Circuit de, let me get this right. The Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps. I like when she says that. She just sounds so sensual. Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps. All right, boys, so we got ourselves a Hennessy Venom. So when we go into that hypercar class, we already have one car down. That's one less car we have to buy. So that's a good start. I could appreciate that. Good stuff, boys. All right. It's, man, I'm happy about that. 500 grand. We just won 500 grand. It's a good day when you win 500 grand. I would have liked that Pagani, but it's all right. Can't complain. At least, if I would have gotten like a 25,000 or something on that. All right, let's see. What do we have here? Driver level XP. Plus one grid position. I don't really need grid positions, you know what I mean? Like, I wonder why we always start towards the back. How do you like get it so that you can start more towards the front? I'd be interested to know. But here we go. Alright, we got three laps here. Starting off in 14th place again. Looks like we have a hard right turn right off the bat. We're gonna be right in the middle of everything. Oh my goodness. Whoa, why were we just, was somebody, I think somebody might have been hitting us right there. That's all right, here we go. Starting off in 16th place. Make it up though. Advanced 1 to 50. Oh, dude. The top group has really started to differentiate themselves up there. I don't like that. I guess we could have used the grid positioning upgrade on this race. I'm starting to learn these tracks, so I don't even have to look at the map. I kind of, like, I knew the next thing was going to be a left. That's why I set up to be on the left-hand side. That's kind of nice. I feel like I'm starting to get the hang of anticipating corners and stuff. You don't have to be looking at the mini-map the entire time, which is a big deal. Helps me to not crash into the person in front of me. Sorry, Zagato Frindo. Oh, man. I thought we were pit maneuvering and we couldn't quite get him. That's all right. So we're in 11th place right now. Getting 3,000 XP. Oh, whoa, asshole, what? Is that Jaguar that did that to me? probably make better use of my rear view and side view mirrors. I never really look at those. Although if you look at the damn, look at the rear view mirror right now, you can only see half of it. What good is that gonna do me, game? Thanks for that. I literally can't even see the person that's directly behind me. Is that not the point of a rear view mirror? You know what I mean? Man, guys. This track has a lot of straights. And that's not really a good thing for us. In seventh place. It looks like we might have a pileup or something up here. Oh no, it's just a sharp turn. I'm gonna take whatever I can get, man. We're in seventh place right now. Woo-hoo! We are gonna have a hard time catching up to those guys. I don't know if we're gonna be able to get this, dude. We may have to switch back to the GTR. This, honestly, for what this thing was, I'm a little bit disappointed. Like, it's just, I don't know. It doesn't seem that fast. It truly does not seem that fast. The Segato. The whole road, whatever, it doesn't matter to me. Yeah, dude, look at these guys. Look at the distance they're putting on us. And look at this. We're just getting blown by a Corvette. An old school Corvette. I want to keep trying. But I'm tempted to say that I don't think it's going to get done. We'll try. Never give up. Never give up hope, baby. Never give up. Not even like, we obviously had a kind of a poor start. We kind of got swallowed up by the pack and chewed us up and spit us out, but apart, like, even without that, it was just like, this is not a very good car. Not a very fast car. It's not like we're driving poorly. Like, I feel like we've hit this track pretty well. We might be able to get third, dude. I think we might be able to sneak away with third. If we race well and don't make any mistakes, I think we're gonna be able to catch this group up here. First and second are out of the question at this point. Those guys are gonzo. See up into fourth place. Third place is just before them. Say, do whatever it takes, man. Oh! I'm trying so hard. We're into sixth. I'm murdering people out here. Oh, man, I think we're done. I think we're done in this car. Ah, I'm sorry, guys. Oh, man. Should we? Ah! I'm curious. Should we? I didn't mean to come in that hot. I was gonna bank off him, but I didn't mean to hit him that hard enough that it was gonna damage our car. I guess let's try this plus three. Let's see if that's gonna help us out enough. Hopefully that's gonna get the job done. Dude, oh, we just straight up barreled into that guy. Let's give her another go, folks. Here we go. Mr. Black Booty GTR, I'm coming for you. Hopefully we can have as good of a start as we did last time. Ooh, maybe even into fifth place, all right. That's what I like to see. Oh man, that feels good, all right. Let's not run into anybody. We're all gonna slow down right here, so we'll just blow by them. Oh boys, this is a whole different ballgame. We're already in third place. Oh gosh. No pit maneuvers. Look at that Viper. It's right up in our jump. Everybody's getting a little saucy out here. It's okay. I can respect that. This is on the outside. Nope. Inside up here, though. Nice. Solid. All right. We're in second place, boys. Maybe it was all about the start in the last race. I think that really was. I guess that made more of a difference than I knew. This GTR is going to be hard to catch, man. Maybe not. Dude, they brake too much. They're too timid. Too timid. It's crazy what a difference a starting position can make. Holy cow, dude. Alright, well boys, now we're just going to be in hold it down mode. I forgot that we upped the difficulty, so that might be why we're starting to struggle a tiny bit at times. I think that's why that last race was so hard to catch up to those guys, because we are, what are we on? I think we're on a relatively high one at this point, which makes me feel good, because we started not very good at this game. That's a tough turn to hit, dude. We still got a good lead, though. We gotta watch out for these straights. These are where that GTR is gonna catch up with us. Man, that's a tough turn, too. I didn't realize it. Last time we hit it, we were just starting the race. We weren't going very fast. All right, so those two back-to-back turns just before and just after the finish line are ones we want to watch out for. This one is a good one. This fly. Oh, dude, that one. Everybody else slows down for that one. You got to use the whole road. Use the whole road, and you're gonna be all right. How cool would you feel if you had this much of a lead on your competitors, and you're like driving by all the people in the stands? You're just like, yeah, I'm a shit. I'm pretty good. I'm not 25 car lengths ahead of them. More like 30. Boys, so I take back what I was saying. I was saying some pretty negative things about the Zagato. I still don't think. I think on the straights this thing gets smoked. There's nothing really super crazy notable about it, but it's a decent car. I just realized that the odometer is working. Look at that down there. We've driven this thing 19.5 miles. It's gonna go up every tenth of a mile. That's pretty cool. Oh gosh. Look at the road, not the odometer, Trev. Hashtag road, not the odometer. All right, we're good. We got a perfect turn on that. Get out of here. All right. We're making our way back around the backside of this track. S turn. All right, so these are the ones. So that one we want to be careful with, and then the next one we want to be careful with, and we should be all right. We'll move into the final lap. One more, boys. This one, sounds good. This is the one we fly. This is my favorite turn. One of my favorite turns in the game. Because you can just... Oh, gosh. What? Oh, Trev. I'm not going to lie. I tried to go extra hard on that one. I tried to go a little bit too hard on that one. No, you don't, assholes. Oh my gosh, dude. I'm not even gonna say anything. If we don't at least get third place here, I might cry. From showing off. I was just... He's pit maneuvering me! He's cheating! Shit, dude! Oh my gosh. Now we're dealing with a bad car, a broken car. It's not turning or braking as well. You've gotta beat a GTR. That's right, this is the guy that was heavy on the brakes, right? Straight, dude. Look at him pulling away. My hopes and my dreams are just dashing away right now. We had first place easy. We just had to hold it down. Don't be so heavy on the brakes, Mr. GTR. Got it, just don't let him pass. Oh my gosh. Oh, boys, we would have had to restart it if we would have got fourth place. I can't believe that we just did that. That was so dumb. That was so dumb. That was so dumb. Alright, I'll see you guys in the next episode. From now on, we're gonna start to take it a little bit more careful when we have that first place position. I'll see you guys later. Peace out.